हेलो।
यस
हेलो
सर,
सर,
यस सर,
यस सर।
ओके ओके, जस्ट वेट वेट। स्क्रीन दिख रहा है?
यस
यस
सर,
सर।
व्हेन लाइट फ्रॉम द फ्लैश ट्यूब इज फॉल ऑन द रूबी रॉड, जस्ट वेट। जस्ट वेट, नीतू कुमारी। व्हेन लाइट फ्रॉम द फ्लैश ट्यूब इज फॉल ऑन दिस रूबी रॉड, द क्रोमियम आयन एब्जॉर्ब्स द ग्रीन कॉम्पोनेंट एंड एक्साइटेड टू द एनर्जी लेवल ए। हियर एनर्जी लेवल ए टू द लेवल बी। आफ्टर एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ ग्रीन कॉम्पोनेंट द एटम्स एक्साइटेड फ्रॉम एनर्जी लेवल ए टू बी। फ्रॉम लेवल बी सम ऑफ द एक्साइटेड एटम्स रिटर्न बैक टू द एनर्जी लेवल ए, ग्राउंड एनर्जी लेवल ए, एंड अदर पार्ट्स मूव्स टुवर्ड्स द लेवल एम। सो द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम एम बी टू एम मीन्स द एटम्स मूव फ्रॉम एनर्जी लेवल बी, हियर एनर्जी लेवल बी टू एम इज ग्रेटर देन बी टू ए। जस्ट वेट, जस्ट वेट। क्या हो सकता है कि द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम एटम मूवमेंट ऑफ एटम फ्रॉम एनर्जी लेवल बी टू एम इज ग्रेटर देन बी टू ए। पहले हम क्या बोले कि व्हेन द ग्रीन कंपोनेंट इज एब्जॉर्ब्ड देन नंबर ऑफ एटम्स एक्साइटेड फ्रॉम एनर्जी लेवल ए टू बी एंड सम ऑफ द एटम्स रिटर्न बैक टू एनर्जी लेवल ए means maximum atom goes towards the energy level m. So the probability of transition from b to m is greater than b to a. The probability of transition from m to a, here look, m to a is smaller than b to a, means the number of atoms, the movement of atoms from energy level m to a is very very few of number of the atoms are very few number of atoms moves from energy level m to a in comparison to b to a, means number of atoms coming from b to a is more than m to a. So the level m becomes more populated. Here, this level M becomes more populated than A. So population inversion takes place in this energy level M. This language is very much important. The probability of transition from B to M is greater than B to A. And the probability of transition from M to A is smaller than B to A. So the level becomes M. In both the case, we are talking about the energy level M. Means the a level M becomes more populated than A. So population inversion takes place in the energy level M. So ruby laser will work. Now here in your in your exam, means in your internal exam, question will ask that ruby what ruby letter is made by which type of material. So in that case you have select aluminium oxide and chromium ion, chromium oxide. Ruby rod is made by aluminium oxide and chromium oxide. The percentage of chromium oxide is 0.03 to 0.05%. Next question we'll ask from this ruby rod. What is the length of the ruby rod? So you can choose, you will choose 2 to 30 centimeter. And diameter, if diameter also, so then in that case diameter is 0.5 to 2 centimeter. Length of the ruby rod is 2 to 30 centimeter and diameter is 0.5 to 2 centimeter of the ruby rod. There are two questions arise from this ruby rod. So next question maybe arise, when the flash is sent through the tube, then some of the part of the energy emitted used for heating the apparatus, but rest of the energy is emitted in the form of which radiation. Then you will choose only blue and green radiation. Blue and green radiation. If a flash of light is sent through the tube, then some of the energy is used for heating the apparatus, but maximum of the energy is used in the form of blue and green radiation. Remember this word, blue and green radiation, which is absorbed by the ruby rod. Blue and green radiation. Okay, samajh mein aa gaya na? Isse kya kya question aa sakta hai? Is there any doubt? Hello?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
No. Okay, next. We are talking about helium neon laser. Next. Helium neon laser is constructed by Javan, Benite and Heriote in Bell Telephone Laboratory, which is situated at USA. And helium neon laser is discovered on 1960. Frank Hertz is discovered in 1914. Helium neon laser is discovered in 1960. And who can discover? Javan, Benite and Heriote. There are three scientists. And which place helium neon laser is discovered? Bell Telephone Laboratory, USA, United States of South America, USA. So construction of this helium neon laser is given here. Means helium neon laser consists of a fused quartz tube. Here, this is the tube, and the length of the tube is 30 to 50 centimeter. In helium neon laser, length of the tube is 30 to 50 centimeter long, and diameter is 1.5 centimeter. 30 to 50 centimeter long tube, and the diameter of the tube is 1.5 centimeter. But for ruby laser, the ruby rod, length of the ruby rod is 2 to 30 centimeter. But here for helium neon laser, it is 30 to 50 centimeter. And for ruby laser, diameter of the rod is 0.5 to 2 centimeter. But here helium neon laser, diameter of the rod is 1.5 centimeter. The ends of the tube here, the ends of these tubes are sealed with a transparent material made up of quartz, are called window. These are the ends here and here. These are the ends are sealed with a transparent material known as quartz and are known as window. The tube has two electrodes. Here at the end of this tube, there are two tubes here. Two electrodes are attached with this tube. The tube has two electrodes at either end across which a high potential, and there is a power supply is attached with this. So high potential difference is applied. Two mirrors here, one is completely reflecting beam and another is partially reflecting beam. Means there are two mirrors, one of them is partially reflected beam and are mounted to either side of the tube, and another is fully silvered, means completely reflected beam of light. The laser beam is transmitted through the partially silvered mirror. A mixture of helium and neon, helium and neon mixture here in this tube, inside the tube, helium mixture containing helium at a pressure of 1 mm Hg and neon at 0.1 mm of Hg is filled in this tube, inside the tube. Inside the tube, helium at a pressure of, isko yaad rakhna hai, 1 mm of Hg and neon at 0.1 mm of Hg is filled inside this tube. The window here, the window are inclined at an angle known as Brewster's angle, theta B. Angle means theta, B for Brewster, suffix with Brewster's. And these are the window. This is the construction part of this helium neon laser. Again, I will repeat the construction part of the helium neon laser. In 1960, Javan, Benite and Heriote constructed helium neon laser in Bell Telephone Laboratory, which is in USA. Helium neon laser consists of a fused quartz tube of length, look my cursor, 30 to 50 centimeter long, and diameter is 1.5 centimeter. The ends of the tube are sealed with a transparent material made up of quartz and are known as window. Here I have written Brewster's window. Look, the tube has two electrodes at either end across which a potential difference, means here both the electrodes are connected with a power supply. So the tube has two electrodes at either end across which a potential difference is applied. There are two mirrors. One of them is partially silvered and another is fully silvered, are mounted on either side of the tube. The laser beam is emitted through this partially silvered beam. Here I have written output beam. A mixture containing helium and neon mixture, means a mixture containing helium at a pressure of 1 mm of Hg and neon at a pressure of 0.1 mm of Hg is filled inside this tube. The window of the tube, here, window, corner part of this electrode and the tube. Window of the tube are inclined at an angle. Here, inclined at an angle known as Brewster's angle theta b. Theta b, theta for angle, b for Brewster, Brewster's angle. This is the construction part of helium neon laser. Now we are talking about working formula. When a potential difference of 1000 volt is applied across these electrodes, then fast moving electrons are produced due to discharge in the gas. Discharge in the gas, fast moving electrons are emitted through the electrode. Due to reason is that due to the discharge of the gas, the electrons collides with the helium atom, first helium atom. As a result, helium atoms are excited when electrons are strikes with the helium atom, then helium atoms are excited and they transfer their energy to neon atom, because neon in front of this helium atom, neon atom are present. So helium atom excited and they transfer their energy to neon atom due to collision. The neon atom rise to their metastable energy state. Neon atom takes all the energy and rise to their metastable energy level, and population inversion takes place. So after the working condition of helium neon laser, there is a diagram, energy band diagram, energy diagram will arise. So the electrical discharge, when electrons are emitted and collide with the atoms, helium atoms, then the electrical, due to the discharge of the gas, I have told. So the electrical discharge accelerated the electrons. These electrons collide with the helium atom, and these atoms are raised to level E2 dash here. E1 is the energy level. E2 be another energy level. E3, E4, E5, E6. These are the energy levels of helium neon atom, and for neon atom. And here E1 dash, E2 dash, E3 dash are the energy levels of for helium atom. Here for y axis I have draw diagram energy. So the electrical discharge accelerates the electrons. The electrons collides with the helium atom, and these atoms are raised to energy level E2 dash to E3 dash. These excited helium atoms cannot be excited. They collide with the neon atom, and they transfer their energy here. They collide with the neon atom and they transfer their energy to energy level E6 to E5. E5. Reverse energy transfer may be takes place. So due to some of the neon atoms, it is negligible. As the collision continue population, neon atom, here neon atom in these two excited state increases. Dekho yahan par kitna hai, 3.39 micrometer. Yahan kitna hai, 1.15 micrometer. So three stimulated transition occur. There are three stimulated transition, stimulated and spontaneous and stimulated emission. If an atom, in that case, we have told that if an atom is on the upper energy level and he wants to jump in the lower energy level, so one or more than two photons are emitted. Here, stimulated emission transition, stimulated transition here in this diagram. Stimulated transition occur which produce laser light have three wavelength. When E6 to E3, energy level E6 to E3, wavelength is given as 6,328 angstrom. And which type of color emit? Red light, red color, which is occur in the red region. If transition from E6 to, look the energy diagram. If transition from E6 to E5, then wavelength is equal to E6 to E3 transition, wavelength is equal to 6,328 angstrom in red color. If the transition from E4 energy level to E3, E4 to E3, then wavelength is equal to 1.15 micrometer for infrared region. This is for infrared region. And if the transition from E6 to E5, then wavelength is 3.39 micrometer. It is also for infrared region. So there are three wavelengths are given here. When stimulated transition from E6 to E3, E6 to E3, in that case, the wavelength is 6,328 angstrom. If the transition, stimulated transition from E4 to E3, then 1.15 micrometer, which indicates in the infrared region. And if the transition from E6 to E5, then 3.39 micrometer transition, means wavelength is 3.39 micrometer, which indicates for the infrared region also. Here, this part means 6,300 region is for red color. 5 micrometer and 3.39 micrometer is in infrared region. So after these transitions, neon atoms, here these neon atoms are rapidly decay to level E2. This neon atom rapidly decay to energy level E2, which is again metastable state. This energy level state, this energy level E2 is metastable state. Here in ruby laser, here M be the metastable energy state. Means maximum number of atoms are present in this population. Population is maximum in this energy state, M energy state. But in here, for helium neon laser, maximum number of atoms available in this energy level E2. So this energy level E2 is called metastable level. To excite them to ground state, tube is made narrow so that they can collide with inner wall of the tube. If they excite them to the ground state, tube is to be made narrow. If the tube is made narrow, so they can collide with the inner wall of the tube. This is the helium neon construction part, construction working and energy levels diagram of the energy level. So in this energy level, first we have told that the electrical discharge means when we have apply a potential difference of 1000 volt, then across the electrodes, that fast moving electrons are created due to discharge of the gas. the electrons collides with the helium gas atom. So the helium atoms are excited and they transfer their energy to neon atom. So if the fast moving electrons are created, then because due to the discharge of the gas, so here the electrical discharge accelerates the electrons. These electrons collide with the helium atom and atoms raise to the energy level, here energy level E2 dash and E3 dash. Helium laser, we only about talking about helium neon laser. So the atom reaches to energy level E2 dash and E3 dash. These excited helium atom cannot de-excite. So they collide with the neon atom and transfer their energy to the neon atom and excited to the level energy level EC. As collision continue, population of neon atoms in these two excited states E6 to E7. So three stimulated transition occur for produce laser light, and they have three wavelengths. When stimulated transition from E6 to E3 transition. So in this case, the wavelength is 6,328 angstrom, which indicates red color. Now, if the transition from E4 to E3, here E4 to E3. So in this case, the transition. So in this case, the wavelength equal to 1.15 micrometer, which is in the infrared region. And here, from transition from E6 to E5, the wavelength is equal to 3.39 micrometer, which is also for infrared region. After these three transitions, neon atoms are rapidly decay to energy level E2. And this energy level E2 is metastable energy level. To de-excite them to the ground level or state, tube is made narrow. If the tube is narrow, so in this case, they can collide with inner wall of the tube. Atoms can collide with inner wall of the tube. Here I have written spontaneous emission rapidly decay to energy level E2. Means here E2 be the metastable energy state, or if the atom jump from this E3 energy level to E2 energy level, spontaneous emission will take place. So again, the atom jumps from E2 to E1 energy level. Means if the tube is very narrow, so in this case, the atoms collides with the wall of the tube. Here collision with the wall, I have written collision with the wall of the tube. This is the helium neon laser. From this, after that, there are some advantages. Suppose there are two advantages of helium neon laser. First is, I have given a notes and go, and notes notes I think it is available. Just wait. In notes, all these advantages are also written. First is, light from helium neon laser is emitted continuously. Second, the degree of chromaticity is very high. First advantages, इसको याद रखना है, ये पूछा जा सकता है. In this internal exam, advantages also may be asked. First, light from helium neon laser is emitted continuously. And the second, the degree of chromaticity is high. So if in your internal exam, question is suppose given for helium neon laser, degree of chromaticity is high, low, medium, or none of these. So in that case, you have choose high degree of chromaticity in helium neon laser is high degree of chromaticity. And here helium neon laser, we are getting three wavelengths. One wavelength according to this diagram, energy diagram. If the transition from E2 to E3, first wavelength is 6,328 angstrom, which is in the red region, red color. Next, if the transition from E4 to E3, the wavelength is equal to 1.15 micrometer for infrared region. If the transition from E6 to E5, then the wavelength is 3.39 micrometer, which is again for infrared region. So if you have any doubt, hello.
Yes sir.
If I have, is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Ask some questions. No, you ask.
Sir, advantages दो बताएं sir, बता दीजिए फिर sir.
जी sir.
Yes sir, advantages.
Advantages.
बोले helium.
First advantage of helium neon laser is light from helium neon laser is emitted continuously. First point is light emitted by this laser is continuously. Second is important. The degree of chromaticity is high. For helium neon laser, the degree of chromaticity is high. Okay, sir. Okay. Now, what are the applications of laser? Types of laser. First is ruby laser, second is helium neon laser, next is carbon dioxide laser, third is dye laser, semiconductor laser, gas laser, neodymium laser, like this. Means 8 to 10 lasers are having. So in your syllabus, only ruby laser and helium neon laser will be given. So you only remember these two lasers, about these two lasers. So another part is applications of laser. First, kya ho sakta batao, laser ka application batao. Tum log padhe ho na, drilling diamond
ko cut karne mein sir use hota hai sir,
soldering and welding sir.
Okay.
Hole drilling, cutting, medicine. It is used for
laser are also used in operations.
Okay. Good. Kanaiya
sir, army use karta sir, destroy karne ke liye dushman ka ye.
Yes. बिल्कुल सही, इसका मतलब याद किया तुम लोग इसको.
किडनी स्टोन को सर रिमूव
करना है. आल्सो यूज्ड इन रडार सिस्टम.
ओके, गुड. नेक्स्ट एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ लेजर, आई हैव टोल्ड बिकॉज ऑफ इंटेंस एनर्जी इट इज यूज्ड इन ड्रिलिंग इन हार्ड मेटल्स और डायमंड्स. हार्ड मेटल और डायमंड में ड्रिलिंग के लिए इसका यूज किया जाता है लेजर. गैस लेजर भी हम लोग जानते हैं, ठीक है. सर्जरी में इसका यूज हो रहा है. इन सर्जरी लेजर इज यूज्ड लाइक मान लो वेल्डिंग में भी हो रहा है, रेडियो टेलीविजन इसमें भी हो रहा है, ऑटोमेटिक कंट्रोल रॉकेट सैटेलाइट में हो रहा है. For the determination of distant stars and planets, it is used in aeroplanes, missiles, tanks. जो कन्हैया बोला सही है. Among these scientific research these are also used for chemical and crystalline structure for various molecules. हमारा आजकल क्या डेवलपमेंट किससे हो रहा है? रिसर्च पर, साइंटिफिक रिसर्च में. इस लाइन को याद रखोगे, इट इज यूज्ड फॉर केमिकल एंड क्रिस्टलाइन स्ट्रक्चर फॉर वेरियस मॉलिक्यूल्स, केमिकल एज वेल एज क्रिस्टलाइन स्ट्रक्चर. इफ सपोज वी आर मेकिंग, आवर साइंटिस्ट वी आर मेकिंग सम मटेरियल, आफ्टर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द मटेरियल they do some characterization like structure. What are the structure of this material? Cubic, hexagonal, what is the surface morphology, and what are the components among this materials? So in scientific research it is used for chemical and crystalline structure for various molecules. For photography, high speed photography, lasers are very useful because it can detect the fast moving bullets and missiles. High speed photography, by use of this laser, storage capacity for information in computers, स्टोर करने का जो कैपेसिटी है इंफॉर्मेशन कंप्यूटर में, लेजर के द्वारा हो सकता है. दे हैव वाइड केमिकल एप्लीकेशन. तो आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन, देर आर आई थिंक 1, 2, 3 10 एप्लीकेशन, आई हैव 10 टू 12 एप्लीकेशन आई हैव गिवन योर इन योर नोट्स. So you remember all these applications. All these applications. Tumor को भी हटाने में हमारा क्या होता है कि सर्जरी में जब हम ट्यूमर को हटाने के लिए क्या करेंगे, क्या किया जाता है, डॉक्टर लोग क्या करते हैं कि वेल्डिंग करते हैं ताकि वो ट्यूमर वहां से हट जाए, डिटैच कर जाए. रेटिना मान लो फॉर आई ऑपरेशन लेजर इज ऑल्सो यूज इन फॉर आई एप्लीकेशन. अगर लॉन्ग में क्वेश्चन दिया रहेगा तो इस तरह का दिया रहेगा कि राइट 5 एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लेजर, राइट 5 एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लेजर. ऑब्जेक्टिव में भी रहेगा तो दिया रहेगा, कॉमा दे दे करके लिखा रहेगा. तो उसमें से हम लोगों को चुनना है. यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट 5 एप्लीकेशन ओनली इन योर इंटरनल एग्जाम. इंटरनल एग्जाम इज मार्क्स ऑफ इंटरनल एग्जाम इज मस्ट. ये बहुत जरूरी है इंटरनल एग्जाम, क्योंकि इसी का बेस, अटेंडेंस के बेस पर मार्क्स जाएगा जा रहा है. सेकंड सेमिस्टर का पता नहीं क्या हो रहा है, लेकिन ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. यूनिवर्सिटी कभी भी लॉकडाउन के बीच में कुछ कर सकती है, इसीलिए इंटरनल एग्जाम में मार्क्स सही, ऐसा नहीं तुक्का मार दिया हो जाएगा, नहीं गलत हो गया, दैट इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. तुक्का मारना इज नॉट गुड थिंग. You know about your syllabus, your topic. Then, agar maan lo tumhara koi